everyone, and welcome to a Christmas Day episode of the Retro Cellar, where today we'll be covering another one of the AtGames handheld devices. Some of you might remember a couple years ago I covered a handheld known as the Sega Genesis Ultimate Portable Game Player. But today we'll be covering this bad boy, which is the Atari Flashback Portable Deluxe. Now this thing has been on the market since 2017, I believe. So it's been out for a while. I knew it was out for a few years, but because of how this thing reviewed, I wasn't exactly excited to get this one. But I saw it on eBay. I believe I got it for $25, which came out to like $38.96 with shipping. You can see this different sites. Amazon, I think, has it going for around $100. Mercari, I saw it for $40. Someone on eBay is selling it for $399. Please do not spend your money on this thing for that much. To be honest with you, I think $25 was even pushing it. Nevertheless, why did I get this? I figured, you know, the 16-bit stuff, one of these things would struggle with. I figured an Atari 2600 era can't be that bad. And I love 2600 games, and to be able to play them on a device that's portable, I thought would be a neat idea. So I just said, what the heck, I'll just get it. But if you look at these things, they're very similar in design. There's slight little changes between the Sega version and the Atari version as far as the shell is concerned. But it has the same layout, same button configuration. For some reason, you get all these buttons with this. But if you remember, the Atari 2600 was just a joystick with one button. But essentially, the red button here functions as that fire button. And the rest of them, I believe, do things like adjust the difficulty level and whatnot. We'll get into that later. So there's not much along the lines of specs on it. I can tell you this comes with 70 games. I will list them right here. If you want to quick peruse them, I'll give you a second because there is 70 of them. There's a decent selection. A lot of the games that I remember from my childhood are on here. There's obviously some that aren't because there's hundreds of games for a 2600. But what is on here is pretty decent, even a few that I've never even heard of. But as far as what else spec-wise is on this, it has a 2.8-inch LCD display, which if it is anything like the display on this one, the viewing angles are probably going to be horrible on it. It has an SD card slot where you can add your own games. I've never tried to do it. I know with this one, you used to be able to go to the AtGames website and download additional games, but I think that's since been shut down, and I don't believe there is one for this. But as long as you download some 2600 games in a .bin file format, you should be able to upload them on here. I won't get into that because why should I? So anyway, why don't we show you what comes in the box with this, and we'll play a couple games on it. Shouldn't have to really do too many. And we'll see if this is something that you would be interested to adding to your little retro handheld collection. Okay, here we have a look at the box of the Atari Flashback Portable Deluxe. It's a decently solid box as far as boxes go. And if you look, you could see some examples of the cover art of the games that are included. It says it's the 40th anniversary of the Atari 2600 when this was released in 2017. Has the 2.8-inch screen. A little bit of Pac-Man there. As you can see, it says it has 70 built-in games. Got a little bit on the side, trademark information, no big deal. And on the back, we have a list of some of the games, and its cover art. We're not going to read them all off because we don't need this video to be longer than it already is going to be. But other than that, that is a look at the box. Let's see what we get inside. We have the instruction manual, which is pretty basic. Just says, how do you start playing, input instructions. Very basic as far as how to add games to it via the SD card. And pretty much, you got safety notice, all that stuff. And then the rest of it is descriptions of each of the games on it. Other than that, it's, you know, pretty basic. And we have the AV out for the device. The charging cable, looking old school there. And it actually comes with a brick for charging. All right, here's a look at the device itself. As you can see, there's the 2.8 inch LCD screen. You have your 6 button layout, with the red button being your fire button, the rest of them being your basic functions, like adjusting the difficulty and whatnot. Have your start button, your reset button here, and your relatively crappy D-pad. I'm not a fan of this, but you know, it has weird travel, the way it, I don't know, just changing direction on it seems a little odd. On the top, you have your SD card slot in the middle, your volume rocker, your AV out, and your old school USB charging port. And on the bottom, you have your power button. If I can get it to focus there, power button right there, and a headphone or earphone jack right there. So you, as you can see, it's very similar to the Sega version. Just a slight difference to the shell, but that's about it. But a very similar layout. So that's a look at the device. So I was having an issue with the battery. I'm not sure if it's because of the age of the battery, but it basically doesn't hold the charge very well. So in order to play this thing, we're going to have to plug it in. That's a first. Okay, so we have plugged in our mini USB. So let's power this on. See how long that takes. And there you go. So here's a menu. It's a basic menu. It says Atari Flashback Classic Game Console. And here is some of the games. Adventure Adventure 2. Bowling Breakout. Cannonball Centipede. What do you got? Circus Atari. Got Dig Dug there. Double Dunk. Fatal Run. Frog Pond. Frogger, of course. Galaxian. Golf. Wow, I remember that one. Gravatar. Got the Haunted House games. Kaboom. Millipede. Missile Command, of course. Night Driver. Pac-Man. The crappy Pac-Man everybody remembers. Pitfall. Pong. What do we got? Space Attack. I remember that one. Stampede. Super Breakout. Checkers. Chess. Pinball. Oh, I used to love that video pinball game. Waterworld. Wizard. Xevious. Got the Yars games. Here's where you would go if you wanted to play games off of your SD card. And that is a look at the menu. So how about we play some games on it real quick and call it a day. So before we actually play some of the games on this, let's really just kind of look at the screen. When you're looking straight on, it's okay. But as you turn it, that's where you get the crap. See, the viewing angles are absolute garbage on this thing. You have to look at it straight on. You know, it's a shame because it's a licensed device. And some of the Chinese knockoff handhelds that we have are actually better than this. Very vaguely, you remember this. Let's turn the volume up a little bit too. Not sure how it really looks on the screen here on the camera, but what I'm seeing through the viewfinder looks like crap. No way that was useful. I remember it being very difficult to get a strike in this game. You get spares all day long. Who remembers Breakout? Jesus. So I just turned off the studio lights just so we can have a better look at the screen. Never really had to do that with anything in the past, but you can see the screen a little bit better without these lights on. So let's give it a go with this. Seems to be a different version of Pac-Man here, not the overly crappy one. It's actually using a, I don't remember this version. This D-pad is garbage on this game. Thank you. remember this being like this if you played with the joystick, but with this D-pad, like, this is garbage. I think we've looked at enough of these games for you to get an idea of what this thing is like and the quality of the games. Not so much my gameplay with it, but we'll look at one more game and that'll do it. Let's play a little Dodge'em. Couldn't dodge him there. All right, that is our look at the Atari Flashback Portable Deluxe. Deluxe, that is an overstatement if I ever heard one. If you're a fan of the Atari 2600 or handhelds in general, I guess you could say this is worth it if you can get it for like 10 or 15 bucks. But the prices that I saw going for on eBay and Amazon, the $100 or worse, the one that's going for $399, if you spend that much on this thing, you're going to just kick yourself in the ass. In fact, I will hunt you down and kick you in the ass if I find out anybody spent that much on it. But for what it is, it's okay. As I said, it's better than the Sega version. And you'll get some play out of it, I suppose, if your battery lasts anyway. But I don't know. I probably won't really pick this up and play this in the future. But I guess that's it, and not much else to say. So that ought to do it. Merry Christmas to everybody. Please like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.